Hi, everyone. Welcome to our new channel, Celebrity Thread. Please like and subscribe if you enjoy our content so we can keep making more of it. Does he love her or love her not? You have probably heard it by now. But during a recent press conference, an international reporter asked Travis Kelce if he was in love with Taylor Swift. So, is it a love story? Well, if it is, Travis sure isn't saying. His response was that he's gonna keep his personal relationship personal.
Are you in love? I'm gonna keep my personal relationship personal.
Perfectly understandable. But seriously, Travis, we need to know.
The personal.
I guess we'll just have to figure it out ourselves. According to William Shakespeare, true love cannot be found where it truly does not exist, nor can it be hidden where it truly does. Do you believe this? It sounds promising to me. So come on, let's put our detective hats on and get to the bottom of this. If love can't be hidden, we'll find it. First of all, Swiftie or not, you'd have to have been living under a rock to not know that Travis and Taylor are the biggest story of the fall. But let's back up a bit, just in case you somehow missed it. It all started way back in July when Travis, the Kansas City Chiefs' record-breaking tight end, publicly expressed his interest in Taylor during the New Heights podcast, when he shared with his co-host and brother Jason that he had tried to give Taylor a friendship bracelet while recently attending her Eras concert at Arrowhead Stadium.
You made her a bracelet?
Yeah. If you're up on Taylor Swift concerts, there are friendship bracelets, and I received a bunch of them being there, but I wanted to give Taylor Swift one with my number on it. Not right now.
Your number's in 87 or your phone number?
You know which one.
His bold confession not only made his brother laugh, it caught the attention of Swifties everywhere. And while it was endearing, most didn't think the NFL star had a chance at catching the attention of Taylor herself. She is an international superstar, after all. However, hearts swooned and jaws dropped when Taylor showed up to watch Travis and the Kansas City Chiefs play against the Chicago Bears on September 24th. Since then, Taylor has attended three more of Travis's football games, and the two have been spotted together on numerous occasions, looking, well, in love. Oh, and get this, Taylor was even seen wearing a friendship bracelet with Travis's jersey number 87 on it when she attended his October 22nd game against the Los Angeles Chargers. It's unclear if this is the actual bracelet Travis mentioned during that July podcast, which, by the way, he apparently made himself. But regardless, it's a very noteworthy accessory. Back to Shakespeare. Travis sure wasn't hiding anything with that bracelet tactic. He clearly wanted the world to know that he was interested in Taylor. And let's be honest, this guy's got moves and he's not afraid to put them into play. Still, this doesn't mean it's love. And what is love, anyway? We should probably talk more about that, because it's really not as simple as Shakespeare makes it sound. There's actually a lot of viewpoints out there about love, including different types of love that can overlap with one another. It's a complicated emotion that we all experience differently. But just for fun, let's check out a few types of love that are based on ancient Greek philosophy. First, there's Eros love, which is a passionate, romantic kind of love, often characterized by intense feelings of desire, attraction, and infatuation. Travis has spoken out about Taylor in glowing terms on multiple occasions, saying she looks amazing, that she's incredible, and one of the most talented people he knows. But hey, pictures speak louder than words, right? Well, take a look at this. It's a photo of Travis looking absolutely smitten as he gazes up at Taylor, where she was seen cheering him on during one of his football games. Case closed. Eros love is definitely in the air. There's also philia love. This is a friendship love based on mutual respect, admiration, and shared interests. Philia is often described as the highest form of love because it's based on a deep understanding and appreciation of the other person. This type of love sounds like it may take some time to develop, but already Travis has shown signs of it. Not only did he travel thousands of miles on November 10th to be at our Eras concert in Argentina, right in the middle of a busy football season, he's also said she's one of the most talented people he knows and has gushed about how his family and friends have only great things to say about her. It's also been reported by sources that Taylor and Travis have a lot in common and have bonded over their high-achieving careers, family values, and charitable interests. Sounds like Philia love is in play to me. Oh, and let's not forget about storge love. This is an affectionate familial love, often characterized by a sense of loyalty, protectiveness, and unconditional love. These date night pictures of Travis and Taylor out in New York City have the signs of storge love written all over them. Travis is clearly displaying a sense of commitment and protectiveness with his body language and behaviors. He even addressed this on his New Heights podcast, saying that he's self-aware and has a feeling of protectiveness when on a date. Hey Travis, while you're addressing things, could you also give us some insights on, you know, if you're in love?
Personal.
All right, fine. He's not gonna tell us. But what do you think? Is Travis in love with Taylor, based on what you've heard and seen of them so far? I think he is, and I think the love he has for her is some combination of Eros, Philia, and Storge. He's clearly attracted to her physically and emotionally, and seems to value her companionship and have a deep respect for her talents, accomplishments, as well as her sweet and giving nature. And I think she loves him too. Then again, I'm a hopeless romantic and might just be in love with the idea of them being in love. Nah, Travis and Taylor are definitely endgame material. But let me know your thoughts in the chat. I'd love to hear your viewpoints on Travis and Taylor and love in general. Oh, and by the way, I made this friendship bracelet for you all. Thanks so much for watching.